Hey dudes, welcome back to Films Presents RC. Paddy with you again. Now you notice we've got something rather special with us today. We're just going to be checking out this 1991 release, Palmer Hemi Coupe. Brand new, as in it's never been ran, been assembled, shelved, never ran. This is very rare to see these in the UK anyway, but very rare to see them in a box like this. So if I just get them out of box for you now, and if you're wondering how you get out of vintage RC that's worth this much money, very carefully. This is already actually sold. Congratulations to the fellow that bought it. Look at that. Like I say, this has never been ran, shelved, admired, never used. Let's pop this cab off here. Previous owner has painted the cab. Who was the original owner? He's done quite a good job, actually. There's some detailing been put in there as well, some graphite weathering, and he's left the windows clear to his compliment. There's a slight metallic shine to that as well. You know, so that looks okay. No cracks in the body whatsoever. What I will say is, this model has been very well stored. By that I mean that you can tell by the tires. If you zoom in here, you get a proper look. Now, if you store these type of foam tires, these open cell foam tires, in damp conditions, you'll find that they'll take on water. And after they've taken on water, if they heat up, maybe put them in a shed, in a window or something like that, or it's damp's got in there and it heats up in the summer again after it's taken on water, it swells slightly because of the water. The cells fill up with water, and then when the sun hits them, they'll split all around here. Obviously, this hasn't happened to this, so this has probably been stored, I would guess, in somebody's house. You know, you keep your house at an even 20 degrees, don't you? So, roughly. So you can tell that this has obviously been very well looked after. Here's the scale Hemi motor that comes with it. You've got some great detailing on this, actually. You've got some the dizzy cap there with some. Your HT leads coming out, your fake HT leads. You've got some braided coolant hose, mock coolant hoses there and stuff like that. The original owner has put some pretty cool detailing on. He's put some pipe ends on there and stuff like that. And he's put some colourful bits on there. He's replaced the belt as well. There's an original plastic belt, which was a white belt. This is now a black rubber belt. And there's a few other bits that he's popped on the lower crankcase as well to jazz it up. So all in all, that looks pretty cool. Moving on to the rear. It's got a Palmer Cyclone 2 motor that's been fitted in there. I think that's a 27 turn motor. Let me just get down there and see. Yeah, 27 turn motor. So that Palmer Cyclone 2 has obviously never been run. They're you know, fairly rare in themselves. Bearing in mind this car is 30 years old almost. You know, we're not doing too bad as in condition wise. You can see it's very similar to the Mardave chassis, the Schumacher chassis from the day, as in it's a fiberglass chassis. You see, it's using the original Minehead screws there, which is something in itself, and a plastic chassis air tub on top of that. One thing I will note is that I can see that it's from the early 90s era because they've adapted the ball diff. They've adopted the ball diff, that Cecil Schumacher invented a few years before for Schumacher. In 91, Palmer have obviously used it on this. So that's quite interesting that it is actually, even though it's solid axle, obviously no suspension, it is got a diff in the back of there to meter out your power. If you were ever ballsy enough to run this, of course. Now, servo wise, steering servo wise, in here you'll find you've got an upright steering servo, which is pretty cool. Nose cones in good condition. These nose cones are actually sort of like velcroed on the side, which is pretty cool. I'm sure you could put a little body post through there if you're that bothered, if you're going to run it. I mean, the fellow that's actually bought this is he's building one himself. I won't reveal his name in case he doesn't want to be known, but I'm sure he's excited to get his hands on this because he's building a 1-1 version himself, so of a very similar dragster sort of roadster build. You'll have to forgive my lack of knowledge on American hot rods. Not quite so sure which one this is modelled off, but there we go. What else did this come with? So in addition to having the 30-year-old Never Run vintage hot rod, there's also the manual, which is in fantastic condition. You usually see these generally got crinkles, wear and tear, as in where people bleed through with dirty hands and stuff like that when they've been working on the RCs, or you'll find water damage from where they've been stored. There's a slight fold on the back, as you can see there. The most important thing is the front. The manual art on the front is undamaged and it's all in good condition. It's been kept in a nice sleeve. Obviously, like I said, I think the whole thing's probably been stored inside somebody's house as opposed to in a garage or a damp shed. Now in here is quite interesting as well. So we've got the scale headers, the header pipes. So these can go, obviously, on here if you want those extra scale details. There's some extra headers in there as well, and there's also some scale mock braid coolant, replacement coolant pipe, and some replacement HT leads, or mock HT leads there and stuff as well. So if you were ever ballsy enough to run this beauty, and if you can imagine to your own horror flipping this at speed, it's good that there are some bits there, so you can, you know, you're not completely without without any bits. Quite notably as well, as the original manual. This is pre 1080p printing, obviously. But yeah, there's the Hemi motor kit bag that's there with it as well, a manual. So yeah, despite this being a 30-year-old RC, like I said, it is basically brand new, so you could indeed run this if you wanted to. I'm not so sure the new owner's going to take that route. I'm probably sure he's going to put this on a shelf. I mean, in years to come, this is going to be worth some money, I reckon. A lot more than what the current customer paid for it. But that's the nature of the game. That's what the trading's about. Move it on quickly, take your profit, move it on to the man who enjoys it. He'll keep it and enjoy it for quite a few years. He'll move it on and he'll get his profit and go to another collector and so on. That's the name of the game, guys. Thanks very much for watching and checking out this beautiful vintage Palmer RC with me. They don't make them like this anymore, guys. Thanks very much for watching.